Hello people, welcome to the first ever Zwift Fitness Women's Gateway Ride. Yay, I'm so happy to see you all, and hopefully we will have a good ride today. This is my first ride, my first group ride I've done, so we'll see. Oh no! Okay, fixed it. But yeah, so this is the first one I've done for a while. I've never led one before. Yeah. So let's see how this goes. I'm a little bit nervous about this. And I currently cannot see my watts per kilogram. So I'm gonna guesstimate until we get out of the gate. Thank you, Pete. We'll do this. All right, so we're gonna try to hold 1.3 to 1.5 the whole time. Stick near me if you can. I prefer it if you didn't go more than 2 seconds ahead of me. And we'll do this. I'm going to just keep the pace because I have no lasso. I can't roll it around and grab you and pull you back. But yeah, it should be for an hour long. Yes, it is an hour long. Sweet. We weren't quite sure. There were a little bit of a hiccup when we started. But yes, we shall do this. So yeah, if you get too far ahead of us, it is not my fault. Thank you for the host or follow. Awesome. So yeah, front, pull back a little bit. Thank you for the follow. You're also awesome. Good job. All right, so if any of you are in any of the chats, feel free to say hi so I know you're here. Thank you guys for all the follows. But yes, this is going to be a social ride. So we are going to talk about fun things. I don't know what those, you have to tell me stuff. It's actually a better turnout than I thought it was going to get because it was so late at night. So the route we're taking today is the Volcano Flat, I believe. So we're going to be doing all of the flat course, including the volcano. Thank you, Casey, for that link. That is the Discord link in my Facebook that Casey just posted. If you want to join in, feel free. It's right there. What happens with Discord is it's voice chat, so you can hear my voice with less latency. So if you're watching on Facebook or something, you can actually mute it, and you would see me 30 seconds behind, but my voice would come through, like, immediately. If you are in Beam, it's a little bit less latency than that. You'd still get it. Or in Discord, if you want, you can actually, if you have a microphone, talk back and forth with me. Thank you, person, for the ride on. You're awesome. Now, this is a women's ride. I did see a male avatar sneaking his way in here. So, we'll see what happens with that. It's a cheater. It's not a girl. Now, I would like to give everybody ride-ons, but I'm not very good at interacting with Zwift while I'm streaming, so. Why am I hearing myself? Casey, if you're in Discord, you need to mute yourself. I think my husband has Discord open and has his microphone on. All right, I don't think I hear anymore. Oh, maybe I do. How long have I been cycling, Pete? I have been cycling a little over a year. It's like I started December 2015. So I rode all of 2016 up to now. I will be right back. Okay, I'm not sure why we're getting a double here. If it doesn't get any better, we're going to fix it by muting Discord, which I really don't want to do, but if that's the only solution, that's what we're going to have to take. All right, so let's see if that helps. Gotta wait like 30 seconds to see. We are doing a very good group. Thank you for hanging with me. Oh, that's who it is. Okay. Hey, Victoria, I hate to bug you, but I can hear myself through you. Everybody say hi. Sorry about that. Let's hope that was that. It looked like when I was hearing the doubles, it was coming from your Discord. It is great to have somebody in Discord, by the way. So, how about you guys? How long have you guys been riding? Oh no! It's not Victoria! Who is it? I don't know. I have no idea who this is. That is really weird. Huh. Oh well. Let's just click buttons and hope for the best. Oh no, I cannot. Okay, there we go. I'm like, I can't see my watts per kilogram. This is like the most classy group ride ever. Totally is. Beginners and everything. I think this is why a lot of other people don't lead rides while live streaming. Okay, I'm dropping a few of you, so I'm gonna slow down a little bit until you catch back up. Alright, there we go. Let's get back to 1.4. That is really weird. I think I actually figured it out. I had to close out of something and enter back into it. And what's weird is the thing that I was closing out of shouldn't have any bearing on voice at all. So, now that we get that out of the way, to continue my answer to Pete, yes, I've been riding about a year. I started just piddling around, and then Zwift Academy happened. And I did Zwift Academy, and I kind of stuck with cycling after that, because it was really fun. And I grew a lot stronger, so that's how long I've been riding. My goal for this ride is, when I first started, there's plenty now, but when I first started, there wasn't really any for beginners or rides that were slower, for people that just wanted slower rides. So I thought it'd be fun to have a ride where everybody was welcome and it was slow enough everybody could keep up. So that's kind of where the idea came from. And then Pete over at Zwift Fitness contacted me about leading a ride, and I said, sure. We have this for 8 weeks, purely because my schedule may or may not change as summer comes, so I didn't want to end up committing to something and then not being able to fulfill the commitments. So we're going to do this for 8 weeks, and we might change it during the summer, and then we might even start it back up again later, maybe focusing on something different. So hello, Casey Shum, how are you? Casey Shum's over on Facebook. If you guys missed all my stuff at the beginning, this is being live streamed on Facebook, my personal beam, I think YouTube, I'm not really sure. And I am also in Discord, which I got working, so come on over. I won't ostracize you. I'm sorry, Victoria. Please forgive me. Hello, Dana, how are you? But I stream on a laptop, and I ride on a laptop. So part of the reason this is live streamed is I cannot reach my keyboard, and my phone app does not like to work consistently. So I figured giving instructions and stuff if I needed to, or explaining why the heck I'm being dropped by my own group ride, worked best coming in the form of vocal instruction. So, good. I'm glad you're good, Dana. You missed, if you weren't here earlier, the craziness we had with double Zuzcana voice, which we finally fixed after trying it 3 different times. Still don't know how I fixed it. But yeah, I like closed a page and reopened it that needed to be open, and it fixed it, which made no sense because it wasn't even something that had sound. Computers, they don't like me. If you guys feel you need to go a little bit faster, feel free to tell me. If you're being dropped, feel free to tell me. I will try to listen. I might need to move my camera for future rides so I can actually see the chat a little better. I usually ride solo, so it's not that big of an issue. But yeah. But we will be able to go up to 1.7 if people want. And we can go any pace slower than 1.5 if people need me to. So say there's somebody who's just starting out riding, and they make it like half the way around. I want this to be the type of ride where we can easily turn around and wait, well, not turn around, but like wait for them to catch up. I want this to be a ride where they can ride for a full hour with a group. Kind of like a no-drop ride, unless they tell us that it's fine to drop them, in which case we can drop them. But right now, we are 46 minutes in, and we're still all together, so we're doing good. So since nobody answered the how long have you been riding question, we are going to move on to the next question I wanted to ask you guys. What type of work are you in? I myself am a housewife. I have 2 kids, a dog and a cat, and a husband I have to take care of. And it's really hard for me to ride earlier than 9 o'clock p.m. my time. After the kids are asleep, after the food's cleaned up and stuff like that, so... So what are your cycling lives like? Veterinary medicine? Ooh, that one sounds cool. So what kind of hours do you get to ride with veterinary medicine, Kelly? Like, are you on call all the time, or... And office manager, insurance agent? Same question for you. What type of rides do you end up having? Yeah. That sounds like it's a demanding job, Kelly. I think it's worse than I am. Yeah, exactly. You do understand. It's hard to find time to ride. And then when you do ride, there's nobody on to ride with. Usually really tired, but force yourself to ride anyways. Yeah, I've done that a few times. It's really hard, though, because there's some days where you're just lazy and you want to go to bed. You're just like, please, let me sleep. Ooh, work on Saturdays really isn't fun. Yeah, I luckily have my husband home on Saturdays, except in the summer that he likes to go cycling without me. So... Even nice 9 a.m. to 4:30 hours. Yeah. Those are nice hours. Nickname is Sleuzer. You like to sleep. I do too. My ideal day is going to bed at like 2 in the morning and waking up at 9:30. I don't really know why. I've always been that way. But my children like to wake up at 5:30 to 6 a.m. Yeah. Usually 8 to 7. That's long hours. Now here is where I might have trouble keeping up with you guys. I don't weigh enough. Night owls unite! Being a night owl is like the best thing, but there aren't enough of us. Now I'm going too fast again. Because I can't keep up with group rides a lot of the times, my FTP is 117. But because I can't keep up with group rides a lot of the time, I don't get much practice. So that's why I was really worried. But I think we're doing good. Good job, people! Hold it together. And like I said, if you're having any trouble, mention it in chat. If I miss it, mention it again. Because I don't know everybody's skill levels here. Okay, so next question. What is everybody's favorite type of socks? Let's start an actual argument here. Do you like long ones, no-show ones? Do you not like to wear socks? I can't see my watts per kilogram right now, just so you know, so I'm estimating. I'm totally moving this camera. I would prefer no-show ones, but the ones I have are about 4 inches above my ankles. They leave horribly horrendous tan lines. I do like them wool, though. I really like wool socks. Can't believe I already almost won time around. This is awesome. Thank you, Casey, for the ride on. You're awesome. Thank you, everybody who's giving everybody in the group a ride on. I think they appreciate it as much as I do, so I'm going to say we appreciate it. I actually think we're sticking a lot closer to what the ride's supposed to be for watts per kilogram than I thought we would, so good job, everybody. Now, I feel like I'm the only person that didn't change my name. Because this is my first group ride, I wasn't sure if they could find me if I changed my name, the people at Zwift, so I didn't do it. I'm pretty sure they could, but I didn't want to take a chance. I like how you like disappear from your bike when you go through a ride on. It's like ghost. We become ghosts. So what would be your ideal ride? I think my ideal ride would be pretty close to what we're having in Zwift right now. Kind of like a dusk ride with some lights. Warm enough to be warm, but cool enough you're not burning up. No cars on the road. Just like crickets everywhere. I think that would be my ideal ride. I like night riding. But night riding in the canyon is scary because then the cougars attack you. Well, not really, but you feel like the cougars are going to attack you. No cars, no headwind, no wind. No cars would be nice. Nice long trail ride and finding new places. Ooh, that would be fun too. I'm actually got a mountain bike this year. I'm gonna use it. I haven't had a mountain bike for like 5 or 6 years. So I'm pretty excited. So I think the theme here would be secluded, except for secluded and or no wind. It's one thing nice about Zwift, there is no wind. Yet, I just know they're gonna like trick it into it. Yeah, I mean, I love hiking, so it's gotta be similar to the same thing. In real life riding Boo. Oh, come on, Pete. Gotta get out a little bit, says the introvert who doesn't like to talk to people who aren't on the internet. So does everybody have smart trainers? I do not. I am riding a Cyclops Mag, which makes it a little easier for me to keep the pace even, but I also don't get to feel what you're feeling. So it makes it a little bit harder for me to anticipate when the group surges or not. Kick or snap? Yeah, I just tested one of those. Those were really fun. I liked it. Kicker? Everybody but me has a kicker! Slow down a little in the front. Some people a little slower on the hills. In real life, ride this evening. 22 mile per hour wind. Holy cow! That's a lot of wind, Steve. I think that would blow me over, Taxineo. Nice. I need to join the cool smart, the smart trainer club. I need to save up. It was really fun when I tested it, so I kind of missed the feeling. I think a 22 mile an hour wind would blow me over. Thank you, Prince, for the way on. You're awesome. So what's your favorite meal to eat before or after a ride? Not like a recovery meal or anything like that, like actual real food meal. I think mine would probably be something with potatoes. I really like potatoes. It's probably hamburger and potatoes. I like hamburger. Yeah, the Neo looks really nice. I haven't tried one of those yet. I want to. I only know one person that owns one, and I doubt he'll ever lend it to us. It's my husband's boss. Sushi. I've only had sushi a couple times. It looks really good, though. I think my husband's would be ramen. I think that's all he knows how to cook. I know it's not, but literally, he lives on ramen all the time if you're not there to cook for him. It's like he never grew out of college. Grilled chicken or salmon? That sounds really good, too. I especially like the grilled. Like, baked salmon just tastes a little too fatty for me. Not sure why. Probably because the fat drips off when you grill it. Brr. So you guys can feel free to ask questions of each other or me as well, just so you know. We're going to try to build this into a nice little weekly group ride where everybody knows everybody, and we're all having fun together. Can whoever's ahead of me pull back a little bit? Where is everyone from? I am from South Dakota. Tiny town called Spearfish in the middle of the Black Hills. So where are you guys from? That was the question. I just wanted to reiterate it. Johannesburg, South Africa? That's a far way away from me. It always looks nice there, though. David Kennedy in Facebook says his favorite meal is beans on toast with an egg and a pint of cold milk. Pennsylvania, south of Pittsburgh. Okay. Kansas City, Newcastle, New South Wales, Australia. Nice, we've got a nice diverse group here. Illinois. Lots of people from everywhere. Brooklyn, New York. Love how there's people from everywhere. It opens up so many more questions. Casey's Illinois, too. Sorry about that. Had to cough. Good job, two up front. We're almost back on you. So, since you guys are all from different places, what is the cycling like where you live? Here, I think it's pretty nice. We seem to have wide shoulders compared to other places I've seen. Other places I've seen have, like, no shoulder. We at least have this. And I personally have never been buzzed by a car. I've only been riding a year, but never been buzzed by a car. So what's it like where you live? Here, it's pretty nice for cycling. Yeah, live in Illinois too, Kelly says. Oh, and as far as mountain bike trails go, we have a ton of them. They're really nice. We get some people from Colorado that are just amazed when they come here, because they're not necessarily as hard as Colorado ones, but they're a lot techier than Colorado mountain biking. And they're really close together. No road riding, no bike lanes, all trail riding. Yeah, I know lots of people like that too. Lots of potholes, not nice drivers. That's sad. We have a bike path and tend to ride on roads. Hit by a car last week. That's not good. It's good you have good mountain bike parks, though. How is your son? Is he okay? Well, I would assume he'd be at least slightly okay, or you would be wasting time on Zwift. But we don't have any bike lanes, actually. We have maybe one in the town I live in. We do have a bike path, but there's a lot of walkers who don't like to move over. So I tend not to use it, unless I'm piddling around. Cycling's great other than today's wind. Lots of bike lanes, paved trails, single tracks, group riding too. Oh, that sounds nice. It's one thing here is the cycling community is really small, even though this is where Cork's headquarters are located. But seriously, the cycling community is pretty small. Is in the hospital, bike destroyed? Ugh. Well, I hope he gets better. Crazy drivers and bad roads. But I really hope he gets better. So I've only known a couple people who have gotten hit by cars. There's a running joke, everybody has to be hit by one once. But it's still scary when somebody does. Last person I knew was in the hospital as well. I believe he got better, though. I didn't know him that well. We have... Ah! You have Trump. Did you know Trump actually sponsored a bike ride for a while? In like the 80s. Like a cycling race. It only lasted 1 year and they weren't making a profit off it. A lot of bike races do that, though. But yeah, interesting trivia bit. Not politically minded whatsoever. Just thought it was interesting. All right, we are halfway through, people. And am I like super in front of everybody? Why? How did I get in front of everybody? Friend, you're from Taiwan? Nice! Hi, Taiwan! How are you? So, if you could change one thing about your Zwift setup, what would it be? I think mine would be actually a smart trainer. I would like to have two. I like to ride my workouts on the dumb trainer, but it'd be nice to have a smart trainer for just riding around. I'm gonna shift down a little here. Road conditions are famously hellacious in the urban centers within city limits. Most serious cyclists take George Washington Bridge. Okay. The current race in Australia, Pacific Island Wheel Race, 550 kilometers unsupported. Holy cow, that's crazy. I don't think I'd ever be able to do that one. That is insane. It really actually does sound fun and horrible at the same time. Chris Boardman, mile record holder. His mom was killed recently on a roundabout near me. Ugh. Riding a bike around here is akin to gambling, but that's what makes it. Huh. 5,000 kilometers. Okay. Casey wants a decked out gaming PC. I could see that. I have a gaming laptop, so I'm good there for now. I really wish Facebook gave you larger windows to view the chat, because sometimes I miss things and I really don't want to. Okay, we're gonna go a little faster, guys, in the back, because we're piddling here at around 1 watt per kilogram and we need to catch up to the guys ahead of us. So if you can, I want you to kick it up to at least 1.3. Look, we caught them. All right, now hold it around here if you can. Like I said, if you can't, just tell me and I will slow down a little. If you can, however, we'll try to keep the group together by going closer to the actual pace. Bigger TV. Kelly would like a bigger TV in his setup. I think it'd also be nice to have like larger fans. Like Casey has a crazy fan. I don't need one that big, but a couple of nice small ones like on the walls rimming me would be great. New MacBook Pro, Victoria says. Everybody wants the shiny electronics. Yeah, Casey has a carpet drying blower. Wind tunnel. Well, that's basically the carpet drying blower. So I think we'll be able to actually do 2 laps of this, which is good at this pace. Haven't dropped anybody, have I? Tell me if I have. I'll wait up for you a little bit. I find myself wanting to follow the leader symbol and catch up and then like, wait a minute, I am the leader symbol. So, do any of you race? And if so, what is your favorite race and why? I personally do not race yet. I have a couple I've got my eyes set on. But, so I can't answer this question, so you guys will have to answer it. Good to sweat so long as you hydrate. Getting hot and sticky is good for training hard hit rides. Yeah, that is true. That is very true, David. You have a road race tomorrow. You prefer triathlons. Well, good luck in your race. We're a warm-up. Yay! We're serving a purpose. All right, we're getting a little spread out. Let's group up a little bit. Okay, there's some people a little bit behind us. Let's keep an eye on them. Try not to let them drop too far. Ah. So I'm gonna target my watts for about 70, just so people know. Because like I said, I can't see my watts per kilogram. So about 65 to 70 is what I'm going to try to do. Thank you for the ride on, person. You're awesome. What is your favorite course? Is it London, Richmond, or Watopia? And which is your favorite route on all of those? I think my favorite is probably Watopia, with my favorite route being the tower climb. Even I have tried it on the kicker. It is still my favorite route. Ouch. Hey, it's fun. Favorite one's Watopia. What's your favorite route? I like Watopia. My personal best for the tower? My personal best for the KOM was 35 minutes, I believe. But my personal best for the tower, I don't remember exactly, but I usually get up there in a little over an hour and 15 minutes-ish. Hour 30, hour 15 from the start line. Victoria likes the Watopia crit. Dana likes Watopia, all of them, and the London Box Hill. Luis says, go, go! Thank you, Luis! We are! I'm coughing like crazy today. I think I need to drink some water as I knock it over. Don't forget to hydrate, especially if you're new and this is actually hard for you. This is pretty close to endurance ride pace for me. Anymore. So I think the mountain course is one of my favorites because when I first started, it was released really quickly either before or after I first started. So my earliest memories of Zwift and starting to ride bike again were of trying to get up the mountain and the tower every single time I rode. So it was the first course that actually imprinted itself on me for Zwift. So I think that's why I like it. What course was your first and imprinted itself on you the most? Any new group riders, Pete? I have not asked yet. Yes, if you are a new group rider, new to groups, be sure to speak up and tell us so we can give you a verbal ride on. In real life, do I prefer long rides or base endurance or shorter and hard hit training? For real life, I actually prefer longer rides, more like exploratory rides and things like that. For Zwift, however, that's where I like to do my training. I don't like to do it outside. I like to do it inside, and I don't like to ride long inside. I like to do that outside. Love the volcano stuff. Yeah, the volcano's nice. How about you guys? What do you like to do inside versus outside? It makes sense. for outside, but you still love Zwift. Yeah. Me too. You like both, Dana? Yeah. So today is supposedly International Pet Day. Yeah, like those are actually national holidays. But whatever. So in honor of that, what kind of pets do you have? And tell me a little bit about them. My pet is, I have a cat named Momo. He is named after the flying lemur in Avatar because he is a Siamese with blue eyes. And he's either extremely nice or extremely crazy. And then I have a dog named Wiggo after Bradley Wiggins because his name when we adopted him had been Bradley. And he's a yellow dog. And we adopted him the year Bradley Wiggins won the Tour de France. And so we were like, we're naming him Wiggo. So what are your pets like? David says he prefers longer 80 to 100 mile stuff, but at a pace where you can appreciate the scenery and literally smell the coffee. Zwift is great for focus workouts. That is exactly right. That's exactly what I think. You have a few pet bikes. Aw, tell us their names. Every bike needs a name. My bike's name is Vali, after the like mythological Norse god of revenge. Cat named Sheldon, two dogs, Huey, and Cav the Cavalier. Nice. Like a cavalier. No, that's not what I'm thinking of. Never mind. Brain right. I like cats. I like dogs too, but it always makes me excited when I see somebody has a cat. Sushi, how are you? Sushi is over on my personal Beam page, so that is why you are seeing his text there and not in the Facebook chat. Thank you, Pearson, for the red on. You're awesome. Stick on, Mo. What in the world is that? I'm not Australian! Pete's from Australia, too. So, I think we'll just make two laps before we go all the way around. What do you guys think? We should do it. Named Cavendish after the sprinter. Nice. We were thinking of getting a corgi and naming it Cav, because then we'd have Wiggo, because our dog is a German Shepherd cross. And Cav, so they look pretty similar. But one would be tall, and one would be short. It would be amazing. I need a Casey mustache to wear. Thanks, Pete, thanks. Yes, yeah, Sushi, we are doing a group ride. I'm supposed to be leading it, but I think we're doing more of a group effort here. For people that don't know, my husband Casey has a giant handlebar mustache. So that's what that comment from Pete was about. Thank you, Zwift Community Live. That is a link to my Beam page. I stream there 2 to 3 times a week. So if you want more where I'm not in a group ride, and you could just sit back on a couch and watch me, you can follow that. It also sometimes has less lag, depending on what program I use. So most of the time, it's pretty much almost instantaneous talking. So how many in the ride? I think there is 8 of us. No, there's more than 8 of us. I honestly did not get a look before we clicked in because all my stuff is covered by windows. I need to optimize this a little bit better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Maybe there's about 14. I don't know, somewhere between 8 and 14. Sorry, everybody! Like I said, I normally do solo rides, so it's all set up to cover the stuff that isn't important when you're riding by yourself. But I'm going to have to move it so I can see the more important stuff when you're group riding. Like my watts per kilogram. Because I keep going up in the listings and I can't see it. It is an awesome turnout. I'm really surprised because there were so many people that were like, I can't make that. I can't make that. And I was like, oh no. My time is horrible for everybody. So thank you guys all for turning out. This is really fun, actually. And be dropped now! For people that don't know, I also have one bite on my bike. So I'm changing just right there. You're up way past your bedtime. Well, thank you for joining us, even if it is way past your bedtime. Really do appreciate it. Got a good, nice ride in, though. Talked to some awesome people. I'd say it's worth missing an hour of sleep. Six a.m. there. That would be nice. Here it is just coming up to 10 p.m. in the evening for me. But worth it. You're in Pennsylvania, right? So you would be like 2 hours ahead of me. So it'd be almost midnight your time, wouldn't it? Getting dropped is God's way of saying pedal faster. Not when you're the ride leader. Yeah, midnight. That's what I thought. That's just God's way of saying you're not paying attention. Stop talking. 3 p.m. for Dana. That's actually a decent time to ride. I would actually like to ride more at that time, but I have children I have to watch. Does anybody else have kids? I have a 4-year-old and a 1-year-old. And they do not like to leave me in peace. 4 a.m. for David. That's really early. Why are you awake? You should be sleeping. I'm gonna sit up a little bit. Ugh. My back likes to crack into the wrong position when I ride inside. I think it's because I don't have my wheel lifted. Heard a noise. I thought it might be a sneaky child, but it's not. It was the dog. Heard I was talking smack about him. He's coming to get me. Insomnia and you work nights? That's a good reason to be awake at 4 a.m. Pardon me for saying this, but you look very young, Zuskana. Don't worry about it. I'm not as young as I look. I am blessed slash cursed with a baby face. I am actually 27 years old, and I will be turning 28 in August. I've been married almost 7 years. So, yeah. But thank you. I'm going to actually take that as a compliment now that I'm getting older. This is like my favorite bridge in the entire Zwift universe. I don't know why, I just really like it. It feels like you're coming out of a test tube. It's awesome. Echo Do It says, I really need to save some money for a road bike. So expensive, but the stream looks great. Why, thank you, and welcome to chat, by the way. And yeah, road bikes are a little bit expensive. I actually got mine for $300 used. So if you look around, you might be able to find a deal. I mean, that's still expensive, but cheaper compared to new. You're welcome, Victoria. I honestly don't mind answering questions like this. If there's ever a question that's too creepy for me to answer, I'll just ignore it. So feel free to ask me anything you want. Next ride, since we don't have time for it now, I might actually let you know a little bit of what got me into cycling and stuff like that. And we'll ask you guys the same thing too, but that'll be next time, not this time. No spamming chat with that now. Gotta save something for the future. But yeah, thank you guys for the ride. It has been really great. Thank you for the awesome turnout. I hope to see you guys next time. One observation, if you may, women are far better at riding as a team than men ride on testosterone. That is probably very true. I grew up with 5 brothers, so I can concur that would probably happen. I think it's partially how we're raised too. Women seem to be more raised towards being a team rather than men who are raised more towards getting it done yourself and stuff like that. And that's not bad either way. It just, I think it affects a little bit how you interact with each other. It was awesome, thank you. You are very welcome. Even on Zwift, yeah. You're welcome too, Dana. And we will indeed get 2 total laps this ride, which is great. You are welcome as well, everybody who says thank you. You are very welcome. And thank you so much for joining me. This has been really fun for me too. Once we got past the double voice issue, everything else went smoothly. So, since there's only 2 minutes left, I'm actually going to mention something. I was supposed to mention this stream. Supposed to, meaning it was really cool and I thought I would mention it. There is a GoFundMe right now, which is going to be benefiting the National Kidney Foundation. And there is actually a cyclist, a female cyclist, doing it. I think it was somebody else. I didn't get a chance to read the entire article. Yeah, Pete has the link. Thank you, Pete, for that. So... yeah, go take a look at that link, and if you can, donate. If not, spread the word at least. And that would be really awesome. I actually know a guy who recently donated a kidney to somebody else. That was a life-changing experience for both the person who donated and the other guy. So imagine how many other people could have a great experience like that, and life-saving experience, honestly. But people do need funds to do things like that, so definitely check that out, because it's really hard to ride if you don't have kidneys. You gotta make new cyclists somehow. So, but yeah, so we are on Zwift Community Live. This will be every Thursday at the same time, which is 10 p.m. Central Time, for 8 weeks. After that, we may take a break for the summer and start up again later, or we might change up the format a little bit or something. But for now, the ride is for 8 weeks long, every Thursday, 10 p.m. Central Time. Also, we are streaming on Zwift Community Live, if you haven't heard about that. They stream all kinds of rides. They stream all kinds of workouts. I do a workout on Fridays at 10 p.m. Central. So same time as this ride started. Tomorrow, I will be doing a workout. They also cover races. They have runners. They have talk shows with other women who know more about cycling than I do. So yeah, definitely be sure to check them out and follow them. You are watching it on Facebook right now, so you know where to find it. If you're in my channel, if you go up a little bit, Zwift Community Live will be there. So yeah, I thank you all for doing it, and we are done. So I hope you guys all have a great evening. Be sure to stretch, be sure to eat something, and if you need to, really go to sleep. Seriously, but stretch before you sleep, or you'll regret it. So yeah, I will see you all next time. Bye! Say bye, everyone! You are all awesome!